morning, friends. Happy Tuesday. Welcome back to the vlog. We are Wit Family Fit. For those of you that are new here, my name is Abby. My husband, Brenton, and I have been on the Optavia 5&1 program for about 9 months now. And between the two of us, we've lost about 125 pounds. So I thought it would be super helpful. We just got a new box, which I did an unboxing for yesterday, but we just got a new box and I thought it would be super helpful to do kind of an official like day in the life on the Optavia 5&1 plan, just so you guys could kind of see what our day looks like explicitly with the timing and the fuelings and that sort of thing and how everything's counted. And so I figured this Tuesday would be a great day to do that kind of a video. And so that's what I'm gonna do. So I am actually on the way to school. It is about 7:35. I finally got all the kids dropped off. For those of you that are new, we have 5 kids. I am a high school teacher and my husband is a head football coach here in Texas. And so we have a very busy life, but this 5&1 plan is so easy. We have been able to sustain it better than anything we've ever done, and we feel better than we've ever felt. And it's what gives us all the energy to do all these things. So, like I said, it's about 7:30 and I'm already sipping on my coffee. I am a chronic Starbucks brat, but only because I really love their espresso and I put it in either a shake or a brownie in the morning. So I will show you, clearly I'm driving right now, so I'm not going to show you at this exact moment, but I will show you what my coffee looks like. This is an everyday thing for me. I have coffee every morning, either picking it up from Starbucks and doctoring it myself, or I have an espresso machine too that my siblings gave me for my birthday last month. So sometimes I'll use that, but I'm still trying to find the right pods that I like. And so I've been experimenting, but I just pulled up to a stoplight. So here is my Starbucks espresso. What I order from there is a double shot of espresso in a venti cup over extra ice. And then I mix either a chocolate shake or a brownie mix with 8 ounces of almond milk. And I count that as half of my healthy fat for the day. I then put some keto ready whip on top and count that as my other healthy fat for the day. So the other half of it. So one healthy fat plus one fueling is my morning every morning. And so that usually I have between 7 and 7:30. And then I kind of arrange my fuelings throughout the day based on when I have a break in my classroom. So that's just what I'm gonna kind of show you today. So yeah, that's about it. One thing I do wanna say is I usually get up between 5 and 6 in the morning, and I usually don't have my first fueling until between 7 and 7:30. Some people say that you need to have it within an hour, but I just find my day is so long. If I eat within an hour of waking up, I'm too hungry and I need to have a 6th fueling. So that's why I don't eat it until between 7 and 7:30, usually on the way to work. The other thing I need to do, and that is always important, is to get at least 64 ounces of water. I aim for 96. It's been a struggle lately, but I'm gonna have a bottle of water today with each fueling. So as soon as I finish this coffee, before I'm allowed to have my next fueling, I need to have another bottle of water. So I just pulled into school. Welcome to the vlog. Welcome to a day in the life on the Optavia 5&1 program. All right, guys, it is about 10 o'clock and I have a little break in my schedule at school. It's my conference period. So I am going to have my second fueling of the day, which I brought one of my favorites. It came in my new box, the cinnamon sugar sticks. I love these. It's just like a crunchy little thing to have. I've also got an unsweet passion tea from Starbucks. I really love to sip on that. Sometimes if I have it, I'll put in a Crystal Light. I don't think I have one at school here. A Crystal Light lemonade packet and count as a condiment. But today I'm just drinking it completely unsweet. And then I'm also going to drink another bottle of water. So I've already had one bottle of water, my brownie fueling with my coffee this morning, and now this is fueling number 2 about 10 o'clock. Now my lunch fueling is like relatively close to my second fueling of the day just because of how it's timed out, but usually about 12:15 I eat lunch. And so I will show you what I do for that as well. But for now, I'm gonna enjoy this, get some grading done because hashtag teacher life, and sip on my water. All right, guys, it is about 12 o'clock and I'm about to head to my lunch. I feel totally waterlogged right now because I just chugged my second bottle of water. I told myself I had to have it before I went to lunch. And I'm like burping because I'm so full of water. So one of the really key components of the 5&1 program is making sure that you get that 64 ounces of water in. And like I said, we try to usually do 96. So I'm at least halfway through my bare minimum of water today. So what I'm gonna do for lunch is I'll take a picture of it, but I'm gonna have my honey mustard sticks with a low fat string cheese and a pickle. That is like one of my favorite lunches. I'm going to bring, and I count the low fat string cheese and the pickle as my healthy snack for the day. I'm gonna bring my tea from Starbucks and sip on this. Usually when I'm eating lunch, I'd rather sip on my tea than actually drink water. So now I'll just tell myself I have to drink another bottle of water between lunch and my afternoon snack, which I usually have around 3 o'clock. If I get all of my water in and I finish my tea, which this can count towards some of my water too. I mean, it's just unsweet tea. But if I get another third bottle of water in and finish this, I do let myself have a Diet Dr. Pepper generally in the afternoon with whatever chocolate bar from Optavia I decide to have, which today I can promise you is gonna be the mint chocolate one because that is my favorite. So I'm gonna go eat lunch in the teacher's lounge with my other teacher friends and keep trucking along on this tea, and I will insert a picture of my lunch. I will say it's super annoying if you've been kind of out of the water thing like I have. My daughter was in the hospital last week and I was just totally thrown off plan. So you feel like you have to go to the potty all the time, but it's just flushing your body of all of those nasty things that made their way in when you were stress eating. So it's all good stuff. So I'm gonna do that and I will check in this afternoon when it's time for my favorite fueling of the day. Well, I say that, I like them all, but I really like the mint chocolate bar. All right guys, it is about 5:30 and we have a wonderful friend bringing us dinner because she knew my daughter had been in the hospital and some of the coaches' wives wanted to help out and bring some meals this week so that we just could not have to worry about feeding our kids and everything. So we are waiting for her to bring dinner, but we're gonna take a little walk, get some healthy motion. I got the whole crew here. Got the dog, the baby, everyone. I'm gonna make myself finish this bottle of water by the time we get back. And this is gonna be, what bottle of water? 5 for today for me? And then, or 4, I don't know, one of those two. And I'm gonna see if what she brings is plan approved. If so, I'm gonna have that. If not, I'm just gonna make another omelet because that was so good last night. In fact, that might be what I make anyway, just because I loved it. But I will tell you guys either way what I end up doing. And then I'm definitely saving room for my brownie as my last fueling of the night. All right, guys, we have made it to dinner time in our house. I just had one of our other coaches' wives bring over the sweetest dinner. She did mashed potatoes and rolls, Caesar salad, chicken, and green beans for the kids. And while I could have eaten the chicken and green beans, I did have a couple bites. I'm just really craving one of these scrambles that I'm gonna do. So I have some broccoli here, and I'm gonna put, I just use a little pair of scissors. I know that's really weird, but I just use a little pair of scissors to cut up my veggies usually. And I'm gonna put 1.5 cups worth of broccoli. I just cut it into kind of small pieces. And I'm gonna put 1.5 cups worth into my pan. And I'm gonna saute it along with 2 links of chicken sausage. Now, I used a different chicken sausage last night, but I made my husband dinner too. So we were out of it. So I had what I've left in the freezer, which I'll show you the brand. It's the Applegate Naturals. I believe it's from either Kroger or Target, but Applegate Naturals. It calls for 110 calories for 3 links, but I only had, and there's only 1 gram of carbs. I only had 2 links in there, so I'm just gonna use what was left, and I'm going to do 2 full eggs and 2 egg whites is what I'm gonna do to make this scramble. Okay, so I'm gonna get this all in here. I'm gonna chop up my sausage, put it together, and I will show you guys how this meal comes together. This is the easiest 5-minute dinner. Okay, so just a couple more steps and dinner is ready. One of my favorite things to do is add a little bit of crushed red pepper, and maybe more than a little bit to some of you. Down in Texas, we like things spicy. So I'm gonna add some crushed red pepper to this, and it sounds like the weirdest combination, but I'm telling you, it is delicious. I like my broccoli pretty like underdone, pretty al dente, so I'm gonna go ahead and pop the eggs in here because the broccoli's been in here, I don't know, about 2 minutes. So like I said, I'm gonna do just 2 full eggs, and I just pop them right into the pan. And then I'm gonna do 2 egg whites, because otherwise there's so much broccoli when you do 1.5 cups. My kids are losing their cool. We're all tired today. I was super glad not to have to cook dinner for everyone. That's all I have to say. My friends are amazing. All right, so I've got 2 egg whites in there. And what I do is I literally just scramble this around. Let me go calm the crying child and I'll turn you back on. Okay, and then lastly, I go ahead and top this with a little bit of green onions. White onions are not approved on plain, but you can do green onions as a condiment. And as my other condiment, I'm gonna use a tablespoon of this feta cheese. It's great, it's delicious on here. I love it, I just pop that on at the end. And then since I have one more condiment left, I think I'm gonna put a tablespoon of salsa as well because we're in Texas and we like salsa on most things. This is one of my favorite brown salsas from a local restaurant. So I'm just gonna pop that we had left over in the fridge. So I'm gonna get this all cooked up, plate it up with the feta and the salsa on top, and I will put a picture in, but this is gonna be a delicious lean and green, super easy. All right, guys, it is about 8:30, something like that. And I just made my brownie. I'm gonna have that as my last meal of my night and drink some more water. It was a real mental struggle to decide whether I wanted a brownie or the chocolate mint cookie bar, but I opted for the brownie, so I'm gonna end my night. This was a day in the life on the Optavia 5&1 program. Thanks for joining along.